Hello, I am Anand Swaminathan. I head the communications, media and technology business for Infosys globally. It's a pleasure for me to be talking to Michel, who is the Chief Development Officer at Calix. Mm-hmm. And Michel, I want to start off by asking you to talk a little bit about your background, because you have a very long tenure in this industry. Can you kind of give us an idea about, you know, your background and how you came to be at Calix?
Okay. So I have like 33 years now in the networking space industry. Started in my career in US at Cisco at the time that this new technology called routing and switching was emerging, which were kind of the golden years of the internet, because suddenly there was this technology called Internet Protocol that normalize every aspect of connectivity, if you want. So Cisco was at the right time capable to capitalize on that technology shift. And I had the role essentially to lead the software group that at the time we took a position to create a software platform. So instead of trying to compete on price, performance, density like everybody else, Cisco took the approach to say, why don't we build one operating system, focus on the internet, and from there, you know, capable to support enterprise, service provider, consumer type of market. So I spent 15 years there, experimented the growth, experiment also the collapse of the web. If you remember in 2000, the whole web exploded as a business model. Yeah. Yeah. So we have to learn how to rebuild the franchise, if you want, to rebuild the trust into the networking space. So I learned a lot more around managing a hard time versus the easy time, which is force a company to transform itself. Then I went from 2009 to 2014 to a competitor called Juniper Network, where I had a similar role running the software, which is called Junos. Different story of transformation. This is where I partnered with you folks in terms of how do we try to get best practice? How do we try to get an honest assessment of our capabilities and strengths and weaknesses, with the goal essentially to be able to grow the business. Then I joined Calix, which was a different venture, which was, Calix is a company that do broadband network. Broadband is an interesting space. It's what we call the last mile. You know, yep. The device we put in your house to provide you internet services is a broadband access. Typically in the way a broadband network was designed, it used to be you build a campus network, you build a business network, and you know, you get what we can provide you at the time, right, in the residential. And that was working for a long time. But fast forward now today, we don't know your persona anymore. Mm. So the point is there's no more private network for the campus. Mm. Everybody share a common infrastructure in the service provider space. And you're a demanding user, right. That because you're going to work, live, and play right. At your home. Yeah. In the small office or the big campus. So broadband right now is becoming essentially the last link between your device, your persona, and the service you want.
Right.
And you can imagine the service now are in the cloud.
Yeah.
And you're producing and consuming the same amount of content versus 20 years ago, yeah. You were downloading things.
Yeah.
So the challenge of service provider is to say, how do you monetize this environment?
Right.
Do you subsidize it from the revenue of the, you know, commercial, if you want?
Right.
Is it a differentiation from a national infrastructure to have broadband services that are gigabit enabled? And ultimately, how do you make the economic works?
Right. So this is quite interesting. So that takes me to an important question. As we have seen the proliferation of devices at the home in particular, and you know, different type of devices that we interact with now, how do you see your customers dealing with those dynamics? Because they are, in a way, providing or doing the heavy lifting, but the devices and the experiences are controlled by different set of people. So what is your view in terms of the dynamics there, and how do you see your customers in terms of the strategy that they're using?
So let's define customer for a moment. My customer are the service provider. So ultimately, they're the one that provide traditionally the connectivity, the plumbing, if you want,
right,
which was in the past either coax or, you know, copper or fiber or mobile. So that was the only way you could get connectivity, and their role was essentially stopping there.
Right.
the challenge they got is that proliferation of device or the service or the experience associated to those device force now the network to have different behavior.
Okay.
It's becoming more and more real-time,
right.
Mission critical, peer-to-peer.
Right.
If you sell a telemetry services for healthcare, it's mission critical.
Yes.
So the network needs to be always on versus
right.
best effort.
Right.
So they have to now decide into what's their role. Do they want essentially to be a wholesale of providing those services on your behalf.
Right.
So you have one point of contact, one throat to choke,
yeah.
if you want.
Yeah.
But you will be responsible to make sure that whatever service you consume
right.
is guaranteed delivery by them.
Yeah.
Or do they want to play to be a retailer, which essentially say, I just provide you the best price
yeah.
for that connectivity, but don't ask me anything else.
Yeah.
And I think their challenge is, it's hard for them because if they want to play the retailer model, which you can make a good business out of it, the consumer doesn't see their role
yeah.
like stopping there.
Yeah.
Because if, I don't know about you, but I'm sure you buy device everywhere from
oh, yeah.
you know, retail, from Amazon,
yeah.
et cetera, and you get the burden of the support.
Yeah.
I'm my own IT adult.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look, I only hear from my kids when the internet is yeah. it's slow, for example.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they're like, Dad, go fix that.
Yeah.
And even my toddler knows what internet is. But it's interesting. The role now that they have to decide is really to define their destiny.
Okay.
If they stay and you stick to the service, the over-the-top will provide that on top.
Yeah.
They won't see any revenue,
yeah.
but they will get all the burden of the support.
Right.
If they try to evolve into the world of smart home or small business,
right.
they cannot do that alone.
Right.
So for the first time, they have to decide, how they're going to partner,
right.
which ecosystem, do they have a brand?
Right.
I mean, think about it. When you think your device, I don't think you think about the service provider first.
Right.
You think about Apple, Samsung, et cetera.
Yeah.
Or an IoT thing. So I think they're going to have to change and adapt, which forced them to have a business transformation, but also a network transformation for the economics. And the role of Calix is to provide them a set of technology, a business model, and hopefully transition the winner of tomorrow toward a place where they're going to be successful, which
right.
is interesting because we're a small company, by all means.
Right.
But we deal with customers that are from small city, to co-op, to Muni, to Giant in the national, to the tier one, and it's the same phenomena in US than it is in the rest of the world.
Right, right.
And for us to compete, I need to be able to leverage technology, open source, partnership,
yeah.
Because I compete with people bigger, way bigger than me.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I don't have the luxury to make too many mistakes, but
yeah.
I have to take the risk
yeah.
to transform my own company, otherwise I can't compete.
Right.
So that's where we are right now.
Right.
It's an interesting time.
No, thank you, Michel. I appreciate you taking the time and talking to us, and also thank you for the trust in allowing us to be part of your journey in helping you to really think through the problems of the future and positioning, and not just Calix, but your customers for
yeah.
success. So appreciate the time.
And
thank
look,
you.
And the last word is that partnership is something that I've evolved over 20 years. What I'm really excited right now is you guys are looking into your own transformation.
Yes.
So it's not business as usual
yeah.
working with you folks. And I think what you're doing well now is you're connecting global line function or sector together.
Right.
So it's not just a matter for you of relevance around the revenue you generate, but
right.
also the type of customer that could shape the future. So
right.
I'm glad to be part of that select club. So thank you for that.
Right. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you, Michel.
Thank you.